శ్రీమాన్ వెంకటనాథార్య కవితార్కిక కేసరి వేదాంతాచారవర్యో మే సన్నిధత్తాం సదాహృతి నమో నారాయణ. ఆఫ్టర్ ఎంజాయింగ్ ద 30 డేస్ ఆఫ్ ఆండాళ్స్ పామాలై ద షీ మేడ్ అ గార్లాండ్ ఆఫ్ 30 వర్సెస్ సో బ్యూటిఫుల్లీ ఇంటర్ట్వైన్డ్ అండ్ ఎంటాంగిల్డ్ విత్ ఈచ్ అదర్ so without any interruption and culminating in the sharanagati in chitram jirigale and the wonderful palashruti of the eternal bliss in this life as well as a forever in Sri Vaikuntham. Now adiyen based on Asmada Acharya's instruction would like to continue with another Pamalai, another garland of verses composed by another Alvar by name Kulasekar Alvar because of his forthcoming Trinakshatram, Masi Punarvasu. So this mala is called Mukunda Mala. Swami Kulasekar Alvar is the only one of 12 Alvars who composed verses in Sanskrit besides the Tamil verse. Swami Kulasekar Alvar composed Perumal Thirumozhi and in Sanskrit the 40 verses called Mukunda Mala. This garland on Mukunda, the Lord Sriman Narayana, Mukunda means moksham dadati iti Mukundaha, the one who grants moksham, the only one who can grant moksham, the only one who can grant salvation, the only one who is the Paratvam, who is the Sarveshwaran. And for us to adorn Mukunda forever at all times, the garland, these verses are blessed by Swami Kulasekar Alvar for our sake. This Kulasekar Alvar's Mukunda Mala is so delectable and sweet, and it glorifies beautifully the easiest means of Nama Sankirtanam, the Sharanagati, and the prayer, the Vijnapanam, the plea for never-ending, never-fading utterance and remembrance of Lord's lotus feet at all times and all circumstances and all places. How, as a Pativrata, one needs to have the unconditional faith on Sriman Narayana. How the Paratattvam is established. All these things are so beautifully talked about. And the Sri Vaishnava Sampradayam is so nicely glorified by Alvars. And this Alvar also glorifies the Bhagavata Seshatvam in an unparalleled manner. And Alvars, there are 12 Alvars. And Alvars, there is a different school of thought about their timeline. Some say it is 5,000 years back and some say it's in the 8th century to 9th, 10th century, from 6th to 8th century. Regardless of when they were born, the fact that their births, their lives have completely shaped the lives of their contemporaries and forever the successive generations of Sri Vaishnava Sampradayam. And even Srimad Bhagavatam refers to the Alvar's appearance in the south. Kalau kalu bhavishyanti narayana parayanaha. Kwachin kwachin mahabhaga dramideshu purishaha tamraparani nadiyatra kritamala payashvini kaveri cha mahabhaga pratichi cha mahanadi. So in the south, in Tamraparani, in Kaveri, in the banks, in Palar, in all these banks, there would appear in the south of India the Narayana Bhakta, to the utter Narayana Namam, and they would appear. It mentions in Kali Yugam talks, I mean, the Srimad Bhagavatam refers to it. And Kulasekara Alvar was born in Masi Punarvasu, Kumbe Punarvasau Jatam, Kerale Kola Patane, Kaustubhamsham Dharadisham, Kulasekara Masraye, Sriman Narayana Murti, Sri Vaikuntha Nathan blessed us with by sending his paraphernalia, the Nitya Suris, namely Sudarshana Chakra, Shankhe, the Katkam, the Gada, Vanamali, and all this in order to send these Nitya Suris Avatari Pitti and make them appear as one among us, as the human beings, in order for us to get saved. That when we see the likes of humans talking about Bhagavad Anubhavam, Bhagavad Vishayam, we would tend to listen. If somebody, if Perumal comes as the Vibhava Avataram, Ramakrishna Avataram, we won't listen. We are dead sure that we would not listen. Even if they appear as human beings, we are not going to. But however, Perumal is asking them to become a Manida Jati, and so that they would appear one among us, and if those Devi Bhushana Ayudam came as Alvar, Panniruvar, and they appeared in all jatis like Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra, male, female, Andal appeared as a female. And so regardless of the birth, regardless of the caste, regardless of the gender, one can become an intense devotee of Sriman Narayana was the message. And these Alvars were Mayarvara Madinalam Arula Petravargan, unparalleled, unambiguous, crystal clear Jnanam, Parabhakti, Paragnana, Paramabhakti. They were blessed by Sriman Narayana because they are originally Nitya Suris, and they were sent by Perumal in order to uplift us and save us. They contemplated, they immersed themselves. That is why they are called Alvars. Aalnd, Perinbathil, Bhaktil, Aalnd, Anubavittadal, Alvargal. They sang the Aravinda Lochanan by contemplating on Aravinda Lochanan uninterruptedly with full of Bhakti, Aparimita Bhakti, Paripurna Bhakti, the flood of Bhakti, Bhakti Vellam Karai Purande. Their Amuda Vak, their insatiable nectarine verses in 4000 divine, delectable, sweet, chaste verses, which are nothing but the essence of Upanishad, the Vedas. Even the Vedas have got the Karma Kandam and all that for either Vishayams, for material pursuits, for worldly pursuits. However, these 4000 Prabandhams are nothing but the sweet Dramida Vedam and the essence of Vedams, and they completely are available for those ignoramuses like us who either cannot learn Vedas or do not learn Vedas, and those who are not qualified to learn Vedas. Even if you are qualified, we don't have time nor energy nor interest to learn. And these Tamil verses are so easily accessible, available for us to read and enjoy the Bhagavad Anubhavam and get saved. And besides that, Mukundamala, the Sanskrit verse, in such simple, beautiful verses, were composed by Kulasekara Alvar to glorify the Nama Siddhantam, Nama Sankirtanam, Sharanagati Tattvam, and Bhagavata Seshatvam, so beautifully, and let's enjoy that. So these Alvars are none other than Perumal's messengers. These works are Alvars' works are non-parallel in every sense, be it in sentiment, be it in Bhagavad Anubhavam, be it in style, the syntax, the lilting style, they, and all of them speak as if they speak through one neck, one throat, one voice, one mouth, even though there are 12 10 alvars, because they are Eka Kantarga. They speak in unison because they all have got the unambiguous, unparalleled Sri Vaishnava Sampradayam and the blessings of Sriman Narayana. They take even a casual reader on a guided tour into the deep, beautiful, esoteric concept of Upanishad without any contradictions or conflicts, and they enjoy the, as if they enjoy the study of Upanishad in original. And it was by Sriman Nathamuni who retrieved and revived them in a beautifully pristine glory for the benefit of posterity, for the future generations to come. The long line of acharyas who followed Sriman Nathamuni and kept this torch burning and handed them over to successive generations so nicely because of their deepest mercy, compassion, daya on us. We can justifiably be proud of our rich heritage, Sri Vaishnava Sampradayam, and it is our duty to familiarize ourselves in the lives and works of these Alvas and the Acharyas. The least we can do as a token of our gratitude is to recite them, read them, listen to them, understand them an iota. If we do that, it is equivalent to Satrallavo Munnam Petradarke. Swami Kulasekar Alvar is the one who was a son of Dhrida brother, a king, and he was blessed as the illustrious son of Dhrida brother. He was the Amsam of Kaustubam, and he was born in Kozhikodam. In Sanskrit it is called Kolapattanam. La becomes La in Sanskrit. And he was kind of Kula's Mudivendar Shikhamani because he conquered the Chera Chola Pandya. So though he was a Chera Kula Raja, he conquered Chola and he conquered Pandya. And that is why he is Kudar Kon. So because he is Kudar Kon, it means he conquered Pandya Nadu. And because he is Kullimalai, Kozhikon Kulli Kavalan, which is Urayur, he has conquered Chola Nadu. Thus, he is the chief of Chola Pandya Desams. And he was kind of, he was so devoted to Lord Sri Rama, and he had such a devotion for Bhagavatas, devotion for Lord Sri Rama. Hence, even when there was Ramayana Upanyasam, when the Upanyasakar was delivering, that Rama was fighting with Karadushanas single-handedly, he asked his army to start marching to support Rama because he went into ecstasy, he went into trance. He said, let's take the army and support Rama, come. Immediately the Upanyasakar said, he has come out victoriously, he has killed all the 14,000 Karadushana Rakshasas and he has come back safe, and he calmed him down. That was his love, that was his zest for Lord Sri Ramachandra Murthy. And in another occasion, because of Sri Vaishnava Sahavasam, because of his intense devotion, his royal duties were interrupted. And hence, the ministers thought, we need to distract him from there and bring him back to the royal duties. And hence, the Tiruvaradhana Perumal's Navaratna Haram, the haram, the necklace, diamond necklace or whatever, the precious necklace, they took it away, they hid it. And when Kulasekara next day during Tiruvaradhanam noticed, he was shocked to find that it was missing from Perumal's divine chest. So he asked the people there, where is it? So the minister said, probably some of the Sri Vaishnavas would have taken, were tempted to take when you were not around, probably. So they falsely alleged on Bhagavatas. Kulasekhar Azad was shocked, as if he stepped on a snake. He was shocked to hear that. He held his, he shut his ears and said, oh, please stop. You bring a pot with a couple of snakes inside, the poisonous snake, and I would insert my hand into it. If they really take, if some of the Bhagavatas have really taken the haram, let the snake bite me to death. If not, they would come out unscathed. Immediately the ministers apologized and sought forgiveness for doing this. The king Kulasekhara acknowledged and understood why they did it. So what he did, he handed over to his son Dhritavradhan, whom he named after his father, his son, and went to Sriranga Sthalavasam, went to other Divya Desams, and with Peraananda Parithar, at the age of 67, he attained Sri Vaikuntha Thirumamani Mandapam. It is told that he went with his own physical mortal coils. It seems he ascended to Sri Vaikuntham with the physical body and to the Kalanga Perinagar. Let's enjoy the invocatory verses, the Thaniyans, tomorrow. Kulasekhara Azhvar Trividigale Sharanam Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Azhvar Emperumanar Desikan Trividigale Sharanam Namo Narayana Adiyan.